G'day folks. I was asked if I'd like to make some threaded brass nipples. My usual supplier of brass has decided he doesn't want to simply supply brass and cut it up for me. So I found in the shed some hundreds of pieces of this scrap X, from which I could try making two at a time. Here we have the tools. There's a deep hole jobber drill in the tool block at the back. In the turret there's a 35 degree turning tool, a 1.5 wide parting tool, a 6 diameter spot drill, and a 32 TPI model engineer threading insert. There's the material stop in the arbor in the headstock. It's just a cap screw. There you can see the head, it's been faced off, and we're just hanging on to 8 millimeters of material, which I hope will be enough. In this video I'm showing one step of the simulation and then following it with the same step of actual machining. Here we're just removing the hex so we've got a nice round bar to cut a thread on. Here I've programmed in an 8-second dwell, which gives the spindle time to settle at the speed that's been called up. That's a Sumitomo FC type finishing insert, which is what I basically use as my general purpose insert. Here we're simulating cutting the thread for both of the parts that we're making. It's a 32 TPI model engineer thread. I know this is only a very tiny thread, but if you have a look at the top of the part you can see it actually taking shape. As usual, I'm using a full form insert, which means it cuts the crest as well as the root of the thread, and to me that's the best way to know that you're cutting a good thread. That tool nose radius that you can see is one advantage that the Windows software has over the DOS software. Lets me actually see the toolpath that I've created has worked properly. The small nib that you can see created here at the center is a function of the backlash in my turret. Until I get that fixed, I really have difficulty getting tools to really be on center all the time. Now we'll have a quick look at the simulation of the spot drill and the deep hole jobber. In the simulation I have 4 pecs. In the actual machining there are only 3. Here you'll see the spotting drill jump about a bit, which is again the turret backlash. That drill should be rigid enough to just remove that little nib that was there without a problem. Here's the deep hole jobber, left over from when I used to work for a living, and paying the extra money for one of those against an ordinary jobber drill, so well worthwhile. Here's the parting tool I'm using. Odd looking little thing, but does have some really worthwhile advantages. That's the neutral insert for it. As you can see, it's pretty sharp. Anyone who's ever tried deburring a hole that small with that large a burr will know how very difficult it is. One of the advantages of that tool holder is this insert. I thought I'd give it a try to see if it would reduce that burring that I was getting, because to be honest that was not going to be fun trying to deburr those parts. I have to admit I was pretty impressed when I saw parts come off the lathe looking like that. The tool library in this software is a little limited, so we only get a neutral parting tool. This software is actually just training software, and I think this version was actually last updated to suit Windows 2000, so it's fairly old. That being said, I do find that I usually manage to coerce it into achieving what I wanted to do. Right, now we'll run through the machining, no simulation, and this will be using the shots that you didn't see in the previous machining clips. And if you hang on to the end of the machining, you'll see me trying to deburr these little parts. I mean, they are just 11 mil long. They're quite tiny, and I had to try a couple of different alternatives to be able to come to a sensible arrangement to do the deburring. Ah yes, full form inserts. If you haven't tried them and you think there's a thread pitch that you might be able to use in a few different sizes, you should really try it. They are just great. They make you a great thread. just cut full depth, get the diameter you want, and you've got a perfect thread. I've cut everything using a 1mm pitch insert from M6 through to M20 and any number of them in between. They're just amazing. I mean, people will buy a quarter tap or a 6mm tap, it'll only do one size. A full form insert will do any size you like. They're just amazing. There are two things I really dreaded when I started using a CNC. One of them was parting off, and the other one was threading. I had images of wire brushing hundreds of threads. With the right tools, it just doesn't happen. It's great. And here I'm trying to deburr these little parts with a deburrer that was just too big. I couldn't see what I was doing. So I decided to lash out and buy something that was more appropriate, and it made life a lot easier. It's just a little quarter or 6.35 diameter cross-hole deburrer, and it works. It's small enough for you to still be able to see the part while you're trying to put it up to the tool. Works really well. I would appreciate it if you could let me know in the comments if you like this new format of a little bit of simulation and then the machining and then the machining right through at the end. I hope it works for you. Let me know in the comments. And as always, thank you for watching.